In the past, we had shown that we can take, you know, simple types of cells and put them together, print them together, and that would create a tissue that looks something like human skin. But right now, there are grafts that are used in the clinic that are available commercially. But one of the challenges is that when you put on the graft, it eventually sloughs off, which means it falls off. Most of the grafts that are available, they don't have a vasculature, which is the blood vessels. And the blood vessels are important because they're the ones that feed the graft from the host. They bring the nutrients, they also help remove the metabolites. And so if you don't have this sort of communication channels, if you may, between the host and the graft's not going to survive. But now we are combining these with more types of cells, with melanocytes, with endothelial cells, with pericytes. And what we see is that we have this really nice functional vasculature that forms in the lab when we print the tissue. But then when we graft them on animal models, we see that the graft integrates nicely with the animal skin, with the animal tissue. But what was really exciting for us was to see that we have connections between the mouse blood vessels, in this case the host, with the blood vessels that we had printed in the graft. And that's exactly what we want, because that's what's going to make the graft integrate. We've always appreciated, as tissue engineers, as engineers working to recreate biology, the fact that biology is far more complex than the simple systems we make in the lab. But these new platforms, new technologies like 3D printing, 3D bioprinting, what they're allowing us to do is really start doing that organization, that engineering, that architecture building, if you may, at the length scale of proteins, at the length scale of cells, positioning the cells exactly where they would appear in the natural context. We also have our eyes on, you know, how do we take this work further, make that skin structure even more complex, more functional, where we could potentially even think of using this as a therapy for burn victims.